Hello everybody, this is Robert Hansen. I'm coming to you with our first review on the drone that is X-Series 24G6 Axis Headless Mode 3-Row 1-Key Return. This is the instruction manual that came with the drone. And I'll be using it so that I can point out some things that I want to mention in our review. Now, before I start talking about any kind of flaws or defects with the actual drone, I do want to mention that if you go out and you're a beginner and you get yourself a drone, this definitely is not the drone for you. For a beginner, because I am a beginner, I found it very, very hard to handle. You have very little control when it comes to this model, and that has absolutely nothing to do with the defects or any flaws that came with this drone. I just would not suggest a beginner getting this model whatsoever. Now, with that said, I want to go over the drone and give you a view of what I found about it as a beginner. The instruction manual, first of all, has a function key, which is supposed to be for headless mode. Whenever I tried to use headless mode, it would pretty much decide for itself if it was going to go into headless mode or not. That was one of the problems I had. With the one key return that it says that you're supposed to get when it's in headless mode, it says that when the quadcopter is flying in headless mode, press one key return button. The quadcopter will fly towards flare. Press the one key return button again or operate the forward backward control stick and the quadcopter will exit the one key return function. Now, for me, I know that that doesn't work because the last time I tried to fly this thing, I used the one key return and it didn't do the one key return. It literally flew away and I had to chase it for 2.5 blocks to find it. And luckily for me, they had these lights down below and the drone was in headless mode apparently, and the only way I could find it was just barely getting dark and I could see the lights. Now if I didn't have those lights, I would have lost this drone. So with me, I've got to tell you that for this particular drone, and I'm not saying that all of them are like that, but this one was defective and it did not work for me. Another thing that I'd like to mention too is they tell you in here that you have different functionings and that it also has a program for beginners, for intermediate, and for you know, people who are really good at using drones. The only problem that I found with that was they didn't specify on the controller what beginner mode was, what intermediate mode was, or what professional or whatever the mode was on here. It just showed a half of a symbol or half a circle, a full circle, or no circle at all. And they gave nothing in the instruction manual to indicate which was which. Whenever I was trying to take off with this controller, I found it very annoying. The reason why I found it very annoying was this has to kick in whenever you turn it on. You turn it on and the light blinks. And it does that. Now, for this, it has two blanks. I know you can't see it. It has two dash marks. For this to connect to the drone, you have to get numbers coming down here. Sometimes it took a minute, sometimes it took 2 minutes, 5 minutes, but this controller did not want to match up with the drone. It took a lot of time, and it never mentioned at all in any of the manual that the best thing to do was to stand behind the drone in order to control it. I had to actually get on YouTube and find that out for myself. So that's something else I wanted to point out. Yeah, see, now I push down on this and I get 000 or 00. And that's the way it's supposed to do. Now, like I said, when you go to use it, sometimes it works a minute, sometimes it takes 5 minutes, and it's very unreliable when it comes to that. Up here, we have our throttles and our trimmers right here. These didn't adjust the drone whatsoever, and these trimmers didn't. I worked on trying to adjust the flight, and every time the drone lifted up, it would always move to this side. Found out later what it was, but the trimmers did not work whatsoever. These, I can push the throttle changing button up and use the drone, but if I push it down, it doesn't work. I can't function with the throttles all the way down. They have to be all the way up. That came with when it came out of the box. So that's another issue that I had when it came to that. And most of the time, like I said, it has had absolutely no control. When I did get this drone up in the air, it was almost lost because I tried to do the one key return, and instead of coming back to me, it flew off and I had to chase it down. Now with the remote or the controller out of the way, I'm gonna get to the drone. The drone looks really nice. It's really sleek and it does look nice. But one of the problems that I have is the landing gear. The landing gear is not secure. All you have is those little pegs. Those little pegs hold it in firmly enough to keep it in there. But once you land this thing, which anybody who watches YouTube videos knows, you're going to crash your drone if it's not if it doesn't control its elevation and stuff. You can watch all you want, you'll see plenty of people who are professionals crash this into the ground. What I found was these kept coming off. As a matter of fact, this kept coming off, I'd say, within a 3 hour period, maybe 4 hour period of trying this out. These leggings came off, I'd say, a good 5-6 times. Another thing that I had a problem with was the propeller guards. I had one of them, which I believe is this one right here. It literally broke and the screws, they have these little screws that are right inside of here. It literally popped. The plastic popped through the screw, and it was coming up on its own. And I had a problem with it keep coming off, and I'm putting it back on, keep coming off, put it back on. That happened about 4 times. Besides me being a beginner and not being able to fly it, the propeller started messing up, and it was clicking up against the drone. So that was the two big problems that I had with that one. I ended up crashing it on the top of our back porch. I had to climb up on top of the back porch to get it down. And then after that, like I said, it flew off on its own. I had to chase it into my neighbor's yard because it bounced off of their roof twice. And I had to jump in their yard to get it out of their yard. And I had no intentions of going in those directions. It went that direction on its own. And this is on a day without wind. There was absolutely no wind in the air, and it just decided it was going to go that direction. So that is our review of the X Series quadcopter 2.4G 6-axis headline mode 3D row 1-key return. Thank you guys for watching. Just remember to please like, subscribe, and share if you can. Thank you.